Well, I'm out hunting. It's in the fall season here in Michigan, and hunting season is in full bore, so I thought I would go out and do a little hunting today before winter comes in. And so, you know, it's very, very common to try to draw a big buck in by rattling, you know. And this is how I rattle. I don't know if you've ever seen, but this is how I rattle to get an interested buck to come in. And sometimes it works, most of the time it doesn't. I have to go to them, and they don't come to me. But I want to tell you a little bit about hunting. Years ago, I lived for hunting. I born and raised where there were ample deer and elk, and family of six, my dad needed elk meat, deer meat for his family. Didn't have a lot of money, couldn't afford quality beef, so we went out and hunted a lot of deer and elk. I was out in eastern Oregon, where I born and raised. And I gotta put on my hunter's orange here, just in case somebody thinks I'm a deer. So yeah, born, raised, hunt deer, and I love deer season. But as time has gone on, some of you know, many of you probably don't know, that some time back, God gave me a very supernatural dream. Suffice it to say that this dream addressed the issue of eternal rewards. I was covered with joy unspeakable beyond anything that you can comprehend using any language of this world. You had to experience the joy. I was covered with it from toe to head, and then it was going inside of me. Then it shut off. God shut it off, and then it took me forever to wake up out of this incredibly impacting dream. But once I was able to wake up, I began to seek God in what in the world I was to make of that dream. And God spoke to my spirit and told me that there is rewards for soul winners that we can't comprehend on this side of eternity. Rewards for soul winners. Now, there's rewards for doing the work of the kingdom. There's a lot of different ways that we can lay up for ourselves treasures in heaven. But because God has called my wife and I primarily to evangelism, I don't want these deer to be able to see me. Wow. I didn't know a whole lot about eternal rewards at that time, but I began to do a great deal of studying and praying and fasting about it. And out of that, I came to realize that all of my hunting, all of my fishing, all of my sport activities, wonderful as they are, not putting that down if anybody else is doing it, because I know we need hobbies, I know we need to have break in routine, I know all of that, because I used to do it for years. But after having this dream of eternal rewards, soul winning, it's like, you know, for all these deer that I have shot, though some people got meat out of it, praise God, it fed them, that's wonderful, God glorifying. And all the fish I've caught, most of them I've given away, if I caught them, that will do very little, if anything, when I get to heaven. Any big bucks I got hanging on the wall that I love to brag about, humbly of course, won't amount to anything when I get to heaven. The Bible makes it clear that what we sow into the kingdom of God is what He's going to reward. And I've come to realize that being engaged in soul winning is priority on God's desire list. He desires that we engage ourselves in soul winning somehow, some way. And so part of how God has done that in my life is to obtain copies of the real life storybooks. There's information in the description section below on how to get a box of those or more for yourself. And anybody can go about putting these out if they can walk, if they can drive, or have a friend that would be willing to do it for. Those books can go out into the highways and byways, sat in restaurants, laundromats, truck stops, stores, where there's high traffic area coming in and out, and just leave them. Of course, you gotta get permission, but just leave them. I've done that as of this taping for over 15 years, just testimony books alone, and have seen hundreds, thousands, and thousands, and thousands of cases of books go. I don't keep track of numbers. All I know, as long as I see God using them, I'm gonna keep putting more out as much as I'm able to do, because I know God is using them. There are many reports of God using them for His glory. But just wanna say, my friend, if your whole life, and this is not a guilt trip, but it is something that all born-again believers need to be thinking about a great deal. And that is, what are we doing with our time? Are we engaged? I mean, I go back when I worked 27 years at the telephone company here in Michigan, and had health issues, back issues primarily, had some heart issues, and I had to really get away from, you know, the stress I was involved in. And I retired. And but for years I always thought, what would it be like to be retired so I could hunt all the time, fish all the time, well, play golf all the time back years ago. But as my back got worse, I really couldn't be swinging golf clubs safely, so I had to give that up. But by the time I got retired, God gave me that supernatural dream about eternal rewards. And my desire to go spend a lot of time chasing deer and catching big fish, it all died up on the vine. And I said, see, I'm gonna be hunting and fishing for lost souls. Hunting and fishing for lost souls. And I'm gonna try to make the best of my time down here before I can't do it anymore and I'm in heaven. I can't witness to one lost soul once I'm dead, because as I understand it, everybody in heaven saved. So it's all down here where we go about trying to be used of God to plant water in the lives of the unsaved. And so with that, I'll just close. These are just reminders, encouragers to help people seriously pray about what they're doing with their time, their resources. You know, if you're an invalid and you would like to help out, we don't have any excess funds to purchase cases of these testimony books. We appreciate any donations we can get. We don't get a lot of donations, but we thank God for every donation that we can get. We do have ministry expenses, of course. Just know that you can give to the Precious Testimonies Ministry, and every dollar you give, just designate that donation to go toward testimony books, and we will be obtaining them and putting those out the highways and byways. And when we get too old and we can't, we will notify people. We'll send you cases of books at a discount, as long as we have the finances to do that, so we can equip other younger people to be about putting out these gospel seeds. They are working mightily. They are just amazing how God is using these real life stories books. So with that, thanks for listening, and may God richly bless you.